we've seen that inquiry-based labs can incorporate different elements of inquiry, from simple incarnations in which students are responsible for designing experiments to more elaborate incarnations where students ask their own questions, design experiments, collect and analyze data, and report the results publicly. Now, let's take a minute and let's think about the kinds of thinking that students are asked to do in inquiry-based labs. First, let's think about a relatively simple incarnation of an inquiry-based lab, where students are responsible for designing their own experiments, collecting data, and analyzing data, but they're not asking their own research questions, and they're not necessarily reporting the results publicly. So, let's think about the kinds of thinking that we're asking students to do in this type of inquiry-based lab. One way to think about the types of thinking that we're asking students to do is to use Bloom's taxonomy, which you've seen earlier in this course. So let's think about which of Bloom's levels of learning can be achieved when students design experiments, collect, and analyze data. This is a choose all that apply question, so before you go on with the video, stop and think about which of these levels of learning can be achieved by students when they're designing experiments. Even in this relatively simple incarnation of an inquiry-based lab, where students are designing, experiment, collecting, and analyzing data, students are doing some fairly high levels of thinking. We're asking them to evaluate, to analyze, to apply, as well as to understand and remember. So when students design an experiment, they have to determine what's the best approach to answer a question. What variable should I hold constant? What am I going to vary? What controls should I do? After they design that experiment, which requires a significant amount of evaluation, they collect data, they analyze data, and then they have to go on and they have to evaluate again whether their results really can answer the question that they asked. And so they're having a lot of experience and support from the instructor in practicing these relatively high levels of thinking. Now, let's think about an approach to inquiry-based lab where students are incorporating even more of these elements of inquiry. Specifically, let's think about an inquiry-based lab in which students are asking their own research question as well as designing the experiment and carrying out the experiment. So in this case, I want you to think about which of Bloom's levels of learning is particularly emphasized when students define their own research question. So this is a choose the one best answer question. And I want you to think about that before going on with the video. When we turn over the responsibility for asking an answerable research question to our students, we're really giving them the opportunity to create, to synthesize different pieces of information, to come up with an interesting question. And so this type of inquiry-based lab really emphasizes this highest level of Bloom's taxonomy. Now, students are still having the opportunity to evaluate, to analyze, they're designing an experiment, they're analyzing data, they're evaluating the results to see if they answer the question. But by giving them the opportunity to ask that research question, we're really giving them the chance to synthesize observations and come up with something that feels like their very own, right? I want to emphasize that adding the element of reporting gives students even another opportunity to engage in this very high level of thinking. Because when students need to report their project and their results to an audience that's not intimately familiar with it, they have to evaluate what it is they need to tell the audience, and they need to synthesize it into a coherent whole that their listeners can really understand. And so incorporating that public reporting element has very significant value for the students' thinking.